because Zerg lose all of his technology buildings. He's in a very well, different position than he was before, and Taran maybe decide to... Oh! Taran just lose another of his dropship, and I'm pretty sure there were marines inside, so it was quite nice damage by Zerg. But at the same time, Zerg have his greatest fire you know, up, so I wonder if he's going to use them or is he going to only depend on his lurkers and the fighters right now. He's trying to kill this science vessel in some way, because Taran without science vessel would be in very bad position, and Taran decides to expand right now. Well, it is probably best because his economy is not in very good shape right now. And he also get another expansion. I'm afraid he might get a bit overexpand right now. And I have no idea what Zerg is going to do. He's going to get maybe some more drones right now, because I can't see any kind of... doing him anything. And at the same time he decides to attack fourth base of Zerg, but there's Dark Swarm and Lurkers, and I'm not sure if he can do anything about it. I'm not quite sure why he sent this Lurker to that support there, but as you can see, this Lurker is dead right now. So it was a bit bad decision by Zerg, I'm afraid. Yeah, just Zerg decided to get more drone, get more cash, and but at the same time, as I mentioned, Taran is getting was double expanding, so Zerg must somehow punish this action of Taran. Oh, and Zerg decided to get Ultra's cover. Well, there is a lot of marines and no tank, as I can see, so it might be effective, but at the same time there is more and more science vessels out. And as you can see, Zerg is having every possible technological building right now, because he has great aspire, Ultra's cover, and he was just able to kill two tanks. It is, I'm not sure if Taran have any kind of tanks right now. Oh, he might lose it. No, he was able to defend it, and very great plague. This plague completely cover all units of Taran. It was very great plague by Zerg. Inshine was able to, I think, to completely shut down this base with Lurkers and Zerglings. Is he going to hold it? Is it cracking? I'm not sure if it is it cracking. I'm pretty sure it wasn't cracking, so either way he wouldn't be able to kill this command center in time, and he might lose his defiler in a very stupid way. Taran is trying to attack again, but another great plague, and this plague completely cover all of these, all of his science vessels. Very great plague, I'm very surprised, because usually Zerg decide to use Dark Swarm instead of plague, but whoa, this plague is just great. I think that he was able to... I'm lagging a bit because I'm casting it live, completely live. I haven't watched it before and it is, you know, live. Whoa, it lagged right now, completely messed up. And now it's better. Terrans get more of fire bats. Another great plague, and oh, he also put plague on his Zerglings. He's trying to kill this. Oh, crackings! Finally, crackings! I was waiting for this cracking since long time. There is a lot of science vessel out, but as you can see, Zerg was able to snipe some of these science vessels, and Taron was able to shut down another expansion by Zerg. A lot of science vessels. I'm pretty sure that Zerg must get some kind of defense against these science vessels. But on the other hand, well, Zerg was very effective at killing science vessels with his scourges, so I'm not afraid. I think he's gonna handle it. Well, Zerg decided to put Plague on SCVs. I'm not quite sure how effective it will be. Because there is the Phalerian no army in tiered base of Terran right now. Another Plague. I can see he's completely abusing his Plague right now. Very nice the Phalerian Plague. Well, this Defiler have a lot of food, so it will be a problem. And Ultralis finally is out, so Cracklings and Ultralis, then I'm afraid that Terran would have very difficult issues with them. At the same time, there's a lot of Scourges to deal with all of these science vessels, but yes, he was able to kill at least three science vessels, and now these Ultras that is going to die, he was able to kill a lot of Marines either way. And there is more Ultras incoming. Taran decided to get some mines because mine is quite effective against Ultras either way. And right now Taran is, you know, retreat to somehow stay alive because he won't survive in straight fight with these Ultras. But he was able to irradiate some of these Ultras, almost all of these Ultras. Yes, he was able to irradiate all of these Ultras. But either way, he must retreat before these Ultras die. And at the same time, Zerg decided to attack fifth base of Terran. As I mentioned before, Terran a bit overexpand, so I'm thinking that it's very easy for Zerg to succeed. Attack him in many places at the same time. There is some cracking in another base, but Zerg decided to retreat either way from there. But his base in his fourth base is under attack right now and he might lose his scan there. Well, Zerg is attacking in every space, every place possible, and Terran, and he's now just using this trick with science vessels and irradiating himself to hit drones of Zerg. But as you can see, he was able to somehow keep his bases alive. Of course, there is Ultras raging all over the map right now. This game is very intensive. And he decided, instead of going to kill some SCVs, he decided to just go and kill this factory. And there is lurkers on the way, so I think this base in lower left corner is pretty much down. And at the same time, one of command center is burning, and I'm pretty sure this, unless Taran is going to notice it, he might lose this. Oh my god, he's going to lose this command center. It wasn't... this command center burned down completely. It wasn't attacked by any means, it simply burned down. Terran was really messy, he completely forgot about it and it was a big mistake. Zerg is losing second, his another base of his. So I can, as you can see, there is all kind of base training right now and around the map. And I'm afraid that Terran also might lose another of his base. I'm really not sure how is economy of both players, because all of them just losing left and right their bases. And yes, this Lucas also is probably going to kill it. Terran army is trying to move, but at the same time there is some Ultra. Oh, show it! Yeah, well, Zerg were completely great at, you know, snapping down this science vessel, but there is more science vessel incoming, so this Ultra is going to be dead, but he will take many Marines with him. there is more ultras and great plague again. My god, Zerg is great with his plague. He simply damaged his so many units with his plague. Well, he's the fire is out of, but I'm pretty sure he has no food, so this 13 kills on this lurker, and this lurker is still alive, but he ended up dead either way, so it's okay. But it was a very effective lurker. Well, Trump probably decided to get another expansion because, well, he must. And now he completely surround army of Terran, but yes, the science vessels is very effective at killing everything inside. Oh, and there is going to be some kind of vulture harass. Yes, but he was able to kill it with his drones. So. Hero drone. But another vulture. Well, I'm pretty sure that Zerg have a lot of drones right now in the way. And he's going to try to surround his vulture with his drones. Meanwhile, he's sending again his army out. He really must snipe more of this science vessel, and he sniped it. My god, he's good at it. There's a lot of fire bats by Terran. Really more than, much more than usual. And Zerg is getting an expansion. He also takes this expansion where Terran wanted to expand. And there is another lurker abusing this dark swarm there. Of course, Terran can just leave. Oh my god, he's going to lose this defier to this SCV, I'm afraid. This SCV wants some revenge, he's going to kill this defier. And meanwhile, Terran is trying... Oh my god, he's going to lose it. Oh no, no. Oh my god. And yeah, this defier was killed by this SCV. Yes, Terran is making this trick with killing drones again. As you can see, it's very effective. He loses a lot of drones this way. Completely clean up his upper right corner, base in upper right corner. And at the same time, well, both of players are very low on economy because they completely just lose base right and left and right. And Terran decide to attack this upper right expansion. There's Dark Swarm, but I can't see any lurker. And she should really just go and kill the Zerg right there, because I can't see any units there. Meanwhile, Zerg just, you know, scare away all of SCVs in one of few mining bases by only using his Ultralisk. And I'm pretty sure he's going to lose this base in upper right corner. He's also going to lose his spawn pool that would be very painful for Zerg. But meanwhile, Zerg just decide to mine somewhere else. Of course, right now he don't have much... I'm pretty sure he don't have much drones. No, he's decided, Terran decided to just run by. And he was able to get one of Firebat out. Well, he was able to kill one drone, not that bad. And yeah, Terran completely destroyed his base in upper right corner. Nothing to say about it. Let's see, I can't see except this one base. I can't see any more bases from Terran. I'm also pretty sure he's very low on gas right now. But at the same time, the Zerg might lose another base of this. Yeah, Terran is just attacking. Meanwhile, well, he's not expanding, I'm surprised. But, oh my god. Shan is like terrified because I was pretty sure he's going to win this game, but right now it don't look too good for him. He have no drones. Well, he have drones, but I'm afraid he's going to lose all of his drones to this very nice drop over there. as you can see, Taran has... And GG for Taran won somehow. It was very great game. My name is Sebastian, thank you for watching.